There was one resounding consequence to the breakup with the other teacher. Shortly afterwards, my drinking started to spiral out of control. Perhaps it shouldn't have come as a surprise. My father had been something of a drinker when I was young, though he did manage to reduce his intake by the time I left home, thanks to the numerous threats of divorce from my mother. The irony wasn't lost on me. My father partially conquered his alcoholism to keep a woman in his life, while losing two women and my own only drew me closer to the demon drink. I never hit Emily. Not before the drink, and not after. It just didn't affect me that way. Alcohol didn't make me violent, it made me negligent. Thank you. Which isn't to say that I wasn't known for my occasional bouts of verbal aggression. That much I can't deny, and I probably raised my voice to Emily more often than I should have. I certainly recall at least one occasion when I reduced her to tears, and there were probably other occasions that I simply can't remember. But I never hurt her physically. That much I'm certain of. That just wasn't who I was or who I am today. I might be a weak man, but I'm not a total coward. At first, my work wasn't affected, at least not noticeably. As the months progressed, however, I found myself substituting the water in my plastic bottle for vodka. Only sometimes, on especially hard days, and only a partially full bottle. No one ever knew, of course, though my work performance was questioned on one or two occasions. That said, my job was never in threat, at least for the first year or so. Then came the day of a certain small incident, and, well... I wasn't violent towards the boy. Again, that just wasn't my style, sober or otherwise. But I definitely raised my voice at him and demanded that he leave my classroom and never darken my doorstep again. I might have even sworn at him. The official report certainly claims that I did. What can I say? His disruptive behavior was difficult enough to tolerate, even when I was in a fitter state to endure such nonsense. But things were starting to deteriorate in my life generally, to the point where Emily's grandparents were starting to intervene a little, and I guess I took my frustrations out on him rather than her. There's no denying that boy deserved my wrath more than my daughter. I was put on suspension since I hardly had a history of these things. I'd been a good worker up to that point, I honestly had. Go sort yourself out, they said. I had every intention of doing just that.
Darling, you can't keep blaming yourself for what happened. Not to me, and me.
The path to recovery is never an easy one, and I wasn't convinced that cold turkey was my answer. It just sounded too convenient to me and seemed a surefire way to fall straight back off the wagon. I suspected that slowly weaning myself off the drink would reap more permanent rewards, and immediately set about reducing my intake. A fortnight later, it was still a daily habit, but at least that habit had shifted mostly to nights. After talking Emily's grandparents around, convincing them this was the first step on my road to recovery, I soon organized a trip to one of our favorite beaches, a retreat we'd been to a couple of times before. It would be a week's trip, during her school holidays, away from the stresses of both our lives. Emily was happy, especially after I explained to her that this was Daddy's chance to get better. At the very least, that was the plan.